want to let everybody know my story of how I came into robotics. I want you to know that I'm not the traditional robotics student that most people meet, like the kid that comes from a family of engineers and been a part of robotics in elementary school. That's not me. In school, I was an average student. I played basketball since the age of 6, and every day I would go to school and go to basketball practice, and that was my daily routine for my entire life, until my sophomore year in high school at Western. I went to a robotics meeting with a friend of mine who was going just to get extra credit in the physics class. once she got her extra credit, she stopped going, but I stayed because I was really amazed at how a team of 5 girls, because Western is an all-girls school, 5 girls was going to turn a box full of metals and motors into a 4-foot-tall robot. So I ended up staying with the team, and I helped build the FRC robot for the game Global Motion in 2010. And upon finishing the build, they invited me to come into the Chesapeake Regional at the Baltimore Convention Center. And when I got there, I got an understanding of the reason that we spent 6 long weeks building that robot and what it meant to everybody in the team and all the mentors and partners that we had. At the competition, there were hundreds of teenagers from all around the country, and it was just an arena full of young innovators my age, some older, some younger, who all shared the same passion for engineering and innovated and building. Since that day at that competition, robotics has changed the way I felt about school as a whole, and I started taking it more serious. Because things I was learning in my science and math classes all started to have a connection and a purpose. I started to understand why I was learning and what it meant for the future and the long-term goal. Because for me, for a long time, it was always hard to learn something without knowing exactly what it was, how it was going to apply in life. So when I started learning things like trajectory and parabola, it all had a meaning, because when this year came and we had to program a robot to play basketball, I had to go back to my science notes and learn how to calculate trajectories and parabola so the robot could play basketball in the FRC game Rebound Rumble this year. And now I see school as my new training facility for my sport. Just like an athlete who spends hours in gyms and working out and all that, I spend hours in classrooms and labs trying to get my mind ready for how I can make new robots like this one that can build more and do more things. I even change my schedule around in school. I now take classes like AP statistics, calculus, I take IT networking. I even have a robotics class now, which is not an after school thing. And I enrolled into a computer science class during the fall at Towson University, so I'm now just a semester student there. Robotics has helped me just change my whole thinking as an all-around field. When I went to my first VEX robotics competition, which is something with small robots, once the team realized that I was serious and this is what I wanted to do, they allowed me to build my own robot by myself without any help. And as soon as I got to the competition, the robot broke down. I was so confused. I thought that robots, when you make it, they're supposed to work. Nothing is ever going to go wrong. And I was looking around for help and asking everybody, and they were just like, you made it, so you have to fix it yourself. So since then, my confidence in problem solving and being able to fix things myself has definitely grown in a large way. As I've built more robots and faced more challenges, I now build with the understanding that problems are going to come when you're building, especially things like robots, which are very little creatures, but it's the problem that you fix that makes the next solution stronger. So the whole robotics experience is definitely, I would say, better for me than being in a standard classroom, because in my science classes at our school, we sit at our desk and we watch the teacher perform an experiment, and of course the teacher always does it correctly, and then you take notes on what you see. But the important part of learning is making mistakes. When you do things yourself and you mess up, then you learn how to fix them, just like I did with the robot, the first competition. I built it and then I learned how to fix it. So it's like when you're building it, you can learn how things work, learn what doesn't work when you mess up, what does work, two lessons in one, and it's your teaching yourself. I really believe that most students, especially my age, they know exactly what it is that they want to do. They just don't have the help around them to push them to get to where they want to go. And me being on the robotics team, you had mentors, you had your teammates, you had the people at competitions that also there to support you. It's just a really loving environment. So robotics is the place where you go that you know what it is. So I knew I wanted to build a robot, but the people around me, they helped enforce it in me and helped show me how to do it. In the last year, I actually emceed at two middle school competitions with the young kids, and the way competitions work is you have 2 minutes, and then you demonstrate that the robot that you spend months and hours and days building is better than someone else's. And of course, because the teams are younger, as soon as they start playing, it breaks down. And they come, just like I was looking at my first competition, they go to their pits and ask their mentors and find teammates and people around the competition to help them. And they get together, and then they come back 5 minutes later and play again. And when their parents come, they get really into it and amazed at what their kid did, because a lot of parents, they think they sent their kid off to an after-school program just to build a simple robot and have something to occupy their time. But when they come to competition, they realize how serious and dedicated their child can be to a machine that they made all by themselves. And the robotics competitions are always full of entertainment, and it's a nice place to show my peers and younger how exciting engineering and technology and innovation using your mind can be. So I'm here actually this morning to ask for everyone's support in sponsoring or mentoring a team and helping the world of robotics in Baltimore City grow and just make it better for all of the youth. So thank you, and I hope you all have a good time.